Good morning, LMP. My name is Abby Harley. The first semester is quickly coming to an end, and you might still not know all of your teachers yet. Well, just to keep you informed, we interviewed one of our new teachers, Mr. Petolia, in this week's Teacher Focus.
Hi, I'm Casey Wright, and today we'll be doing a teacher spotlight on the new chemistry teacher, Mr. Petolia.
I think LMP is a small school, and my feeling so far has been that there is a degree, like a community feeling here. Everybody seems to help each other out. Everybody seems to work well with each other. And even though there are so many people who are here from different countries, people work well with each other, which is really good to see because I've seen people help each other out with homework, with other problems. And I've seen people hang out together over the weekend at dorm as well. So it's a great feeling. I did my undergraduate in pharmacy in India. So after I graduated from in a pharmacy college in India, I started working as a pharmacist for a short time. And then I went to Australia for my MBA, and I was working in pharmaceutical marketing. Eventually got married, and then I moved to United States to be with my wife. My favorite memory, this I never forget. I think in the first week or so, I did a demonstration for all my students in the sort of in the playground behind the cafeteria. And once the demonstration was done, everybody started clapping. And that was a very humbling experience. Students really appreciated what I did for them. And I think that I'll never forget that moment.
Mr. Petolio is also the bowling coach.
This was my first year of bowling coach, yes. Coaching is slightly different than regular teaching. And so it was a new experience for me. And I wanted to branch out from traditional teaching role as well. I didn't want to be just a teacher and to be in the classroom. I wanted to be more involved in students' academic as well as in their athletic performances. We have about 7 boys, and obviously next year the numbers will be different. Our girls' team is a bit more stronger than the boys' team. However, we only have 4 girls in the team, whereas you need 5 girls to make a team. So our performance was not as stellar as I would have liked. But I'm guessing that over time, we would be able to develop this program of bowling at LMP, and then, you know, we would have a much more robust team, which would do better than this year's performance.
Stay tuned for more GNN, including Griffin Center, after these messages.
Starting now until December 12th, the World Language Honor Society is hosting a winter clothes drive for the less fortunate. They are collecting the following items for the Orlando Coalition for the Homeless: coats, jackets, gloves, and hats. The donation boxes are located in the upper and lower school lobbies. Let's give back to the less fortunate. Happy holidays.
December 7th, 1941. The U.S. Naval Base Pearl Harbor in Hawaii was attacked and bombed by nearly 200 Japanese aircraft in a raid that lasted just over 1 hour and left 3,000 Americans dead. The USS Shaw exploded during the Japanese air raid. That alone killed 1,104 people. President Franklin Roosevelt tried to make a peace treaty with the Emperor of Japan. There was no response. Later on, some of the military's radios picked up a coded message that they interpreted that an attack on Southeast Asia was imminent. December 8th, 1980. Former Beatle musician John Lennon was assassinated in New York City. He was shot twice in the back while in front of his apartment building. The broadcast interrupted a sportsman speaking. The crowds went silent. It was a tragedy that not one person liked. Then a short uproar of people in the stadiums got angry with grief.
Do you like to put things together or take things apart? Have you ever wondered how a computer works? Or how people learn to write computer programs and create video games? Then Coders and Tinkers is for you. Coders and Tinkers is a club where activities range from building a computer program to creating robots that actually move around. So what are you waiting for? Come to Dr. Cedar's room next Thursday and join.
Welcome back. No Shave November recently ended, and once again, the students and teachers came through with amazing donations and sometimes looking foolish, but all for a good cause. Here are your winners.
Thank you.
I am Batman.
Basketball got their first win over break, and Matt Upper joining us live to talk about this win. Also, boys and girls varsity soccer teams square up for some games this week, all coming up next on Griffin Center, right now. Hello, I'm Casey Wright, and welcome to Griffin Center. The girls varsity soccer team played Crooms on Tuesday. Here are some highlights from this match.
Griffins versus Crooms in this one, let's go. Started out very strong for the Lady Griffins, Nina Karlinski with this dime right here. But Nina comes again downfield, crosses the goalie, and Nina.
Just tap it in. Just tap it in. Give it a little tappy. Tap, tap, tap-a-roo.
She wasn't finished, though. A snipe from across the field. She got it. And bartender, give me a fourth. Nina had 5 goals in the 6-1 win over Croons. 8th grader Emily Rude added to the fun, scoring one as well.
Boys varsity soccer will play here at home versus Forest Lake today at 4:30. They will also play St. Cloud here at LMP tomorrow at 7. The girls varsity basketball team has their first sister games this week versus Mount Dora Bible, which is an away game, and Father Lopez, which is home at Friday at 6. Come out and support your Lady Griffin. Varsity basketball got their first win of the season over the break versus Tavares. The Griffins defeated them 58-55. They will go on to play their first district games this week, including Father Lopez, here at LMP at 7:30. We're going to need Griffin Nation at this game, so do not miss it. Now here's Jaron Harden with a boys' basketball preview of this season.
Hi, I'm Jared Harden, and today I'm going to be giving you an exclusive look at this year's boys' varsity basketball team.
Looking forward to the basketball season, and really because, you know, it's just my last year in the just trying to win a district championship.
You know, we put in a lot of work. We really want to be successful this year, more so than last year. I think we got the leaders and the right pieces to do it. So we were looking for a district championship. I think our team's got a lot of potential. We're super young. We only have 3 seniors and like 4 total upperclassmen. So there's a lot of like inexperienced players, but there's a lot of experienced players that are good leaders and know what they're doing out there. So I think if we can help the young guys learn along the way, we have a chance to be successful and accomplish our goals.
Toughest competition probably be Evans if they do come to our tournament, and if not Evans, probably Lake Mary.
You can now see that this year's team is excited for the new season. The players worked vigorously in the offseason, so it is important that we come out and show our support for the team as they bring home a district title. I'm Jared Harden, signing off for GNN.
I have a member of the boys' varsity basketball team, Matt Upper, joining me live here on Griffin Center. Matt, what is your impression of the season so far of this team?
So far this season, we started off a little slow, you know, but we just got our win last Saturday, and we're starting district play this week, so hopefully we'll come out with 2 big district wins, and we'll be good to go from there.
Now, Matt, tell me, what are the strengths you guys have, and also tell me some of the weaknesses you guys have that you guys are going to need to fix?
Some of the strengths we have are we're really deep. We have a solid rotation going. Another strength is that we're all young. We only have 2 seniors, 3 seniors. One of them doesn't play. But that's also a weakness because we're young, immature, don't have a lot of experience.
Also, as you guys grow, what does the future hold for this Griffins varsity basketball team?
We're all looking forward to the future. We got a great young JV team. We have 5 sophomores and 2 or 3 juniors on the team right now, so real young, and we'll just get better as time goes on.
Thanks, Matt. Good luck for the rest of your season, and I wish you guys the best. Thanks for watching. I'm Casey Wright, and this is Griffin Center.
Thanks, everyone. We hope you had a great week, and exams are right around the corner, so be prepared and study hard. Have a great winter break, and stay classy, LMP.